Hello, welcome to the Z Hut. Today, I'm going to show you how to add an audio alarm to your mouse trap so that you know when you've got a mouse without having to go and actually visually inspect the mouse trap. Now, there's many applications for this, and the reason I designed this is because I don't need mouse traps in my house. I have three cats. And if a mouse gets in here, he's up the creek without a paddle. It's an appetizer and play toy. So I do need mouse traps in my garage. And instead of having to go out and visually inspect them all the time, I came up with this little project of adding an alarm to let me know when the trap has been triggered without actually having to go out into the garage. I just stick my head out the door every couple hours and listen. And when the alarm is going off, well, go out, take the mouse out, reset the trap, good to go. All right, well, I'm gonna move the camera in here to the workbench and I'll show you how to build this. See you there in just a moment. Okay, well, I've removed the trap and circuitry from that piece of plywood. Now, if you do build this, I do recommend mounting this on a piece of plywood. If you don't have a piece of plywood, a small chunk of 2x4 would work as well. The main reason is it's going to keep the trap from flipping around when it goes off and unplugging. And then, of course, your alarm ain't going to go off. Also, if by chance you have rats, they're cannibals, man. They'll grab that mouse trap and haul the whole thing off. And you'll have to dig through your walls or dig a hole for wherever they ran off with your stuff. So just mount it on a piece of plywood, little piece of 2x4, anything, just something to weight it down. And like I said, also it keeps the trap, because when it goes off, it might flip over or something, and that'll keep it from getting unplugged. All right, y'all. What I'll do next here is I'll show you it working. So I got it powered up, and I'm just going to trigger the trap. There we go. And then when you put that back down, alarm goes off. All right. Let me disconnect the power. Now what we have here is a photo interrupter. And these are pretty easy to scavenge. If you've got an old junk printer, you can find these in there. This particular one came out of a garage door opener, and they're about the same size as the ones out of printers and fax machines. What it does is, you can see I got a little piece of black tape mounted around, and actually under that I have a little tab I soldered on. That's not necessary. I just did it. It gives more stability. Otherwise, you just put the piece of black tape, and when you have the trap set, it's blocking the connection, because on one side you have an infrared LED, the other side you have an infrared transistor. So when that opens up, what it's doing is it's sending signal, because now the electricity can run through the infrared transistor. It's going into the circuit, and it's going to this 2N2222 transistor, and opening that and applying the voltage to the 555 timer, which produces the tone that sets the alarm off, gives you the audio alarm on the speaker. This is a real simple project to build. If you're a beginner in electronics, give this a try. This is a real easy project, and it's kind of fun. And the nice thing is, I mean, if the trap goes off, you don't have to go and actually visually inspect it. You just listen. There's a tone. Well, that means it sprung. Now, another thing I'd like to mention, look in the description below. I have another video on how to bait mouse traps to get the mouse 99% of the time. Because what lots of people do is they'll put peanut butter or spreadable cheese on the trap. And you do that, honestly, truthfully, you're pretty much 80% of the time giving the mouse a free snack. And that's what you're doing because they'll just sit there and lick it. It's not going to trigger it. So check out that video. I'll show you how to bait this mouse trap where you're going to get the mouse pretty much every time. Now, like I said, we got the photo interrupter, the 555 timer. We got a couple resistors, capacitors, and the capacitors on here. If you play around with them a little, they're supposed to be around 10 nanofarads, but if you play around a little lower, a little higher, you'll get a different tone than what you heard I had. And just stay, I wouldn't go much lower than 5 nanofarads and not too much over 20. Right in that ballpark range, you'll get different tones, so that'll work for you. And then, hey, if you're good at soldering, get one of these little boards. You could solder this up on here real easy, real easy. And then put this in a real small enclosure. And for the speaker, I'm just using a little 8-ohm. Whoop. Actually, moving it there, I broke the connection. I'll have to resolder that. My bad. But, you could also use those little speakers out of your computer. And those are real cheap. If you don't have one, you could order one. Otherwise, a pair of headphones that's junk. Cut the speaker out of that and hook it up. It'll work. And this project is real easy to build. For the schematic, here is a schematic I drew it up. Go to my website. You can download this and print it out. And you're definitely going to want to print it out because it makes it easier to build this. Then also on the website, I'll have links to find all these parts if you don't have them. And then also, I'll have a little section because this photo interrupter I'm using here, I scavenged out of garage door opener. I could not find the data sheet on it. So I just used my multimeter and figured it out myself. And on the website, I'll show you how to do that in case you're scavenging one of these out of a printer or the garage door opener or wherever you scavenge one. You can't find the data sheet. I'll show you how to figure this out and do it. Otherwise, if you've got the data sheet, well, it'll help you out because then you know what resistance to use for the infrared LED. With that, I think we can wrap this tutorial up. Well, I would like to thank you for joining us here at the Z Hut today. Hope you found this information useful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, really would. And also consider subscribing. I'm going to be doing some more videos real soon here, and I'm going to do a variation of this. Instead of having the audio alarm, I'm going to have a Bluetooth alarm where you just turn your cell phone or your tablet on, and you can check to see if your trap is sprung. And that should be up within about a week after this video. So make sure you subscribe or just look on the website and you'll find a link for that too. So thanks for joining us here today at the Z Hut. Have fun building.